Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how you can build a multi-layered up and down water elevator which is almost completely hidden within the corner of a room, as you can see right here. This build was heavily inspired by a recent video from Mumbo Jumbo where he designed a self-building water elevator, but this one here is multi-layered and also uses some different mechanics which allowed it to be quite a bit more compact and also cheaper. Anyway, let's show you this in action. So basically all you have to do is stand in this corner here and then you have two buttons, one to go down and one to go up, of course. So let's start with going down. All you have to do is press the button and then the entire thing here will start to open up. And then after a short delay, I'm down here. Now let's go in the opposite direction. Let's go up. And that also works properly, as you can see here. Now let's go up a bigger distance. As you can see, this works just the same. Due to simplicity reasons, the timer for going up and down a given water tube here is the same, since going up and down in water, even with the soil sand and magma blocks, takes a different time. You will have to actually wait in one direction a bit. Anyway, down here also works properly, as you can see there. And I'm back down here again. So this is basically how this thing works. So next up, let's talk about the size of the entire thing. So in total, it's 6 blocks wide, 7 blocks long, and each module has a height of 10 blocks. Those modules can be stacked directly on top of each other, which makes a minimum distance between floors of 10 blocks. The distance can be further. Then you have a simple 3x3 water tube in between those modules. Next up, let's talk about the resources. So for each module, except for the topmost one, which is more or less that what is left out in the bottommost one. So you're gonna need those resources times the number of floors minus one. So those resources are, of course, building blocks, then four slabs, 17 stairs, a single magma block and a single soil sand block. Don't let yourself get confused that I'm using polished andesite for those here during the first building process. I later on decided to use polished quartz here for optical reasons, obviously. Anyway, for redstone resources, it's a redstone block, 24 redstone dust, 13 redstone torches, 10 repeaters, 2 comparators, 6 observers, a single normal piston, 17 sticky pistons, 3 dispensers, each filled with a water bucket, 2 hoppers, 2 nut blocks and 4 buttons. And then for the water tube, as you can see, there are basically 2 power lines, which means that at the minimum for 5 blocks of height of the water tube, you're gonna need for one of those lines 2 blocks, an observer, a nut block and a redstone dust. And for 4 blocks of height, for the other block, other line, you need 2 blocks and 2 redstone torches, since this is just a simple redstone torch tower right there. And now before we get to the actual building process, one last remark, and that has to do with this visible soil sand block here. You might say this is not completely hidden, but there is not really a way around this for a very simple reason. My first designs didn't have this one here, and when I was going down there, landed on here and then the swapper action happened, I would be left in a kind of half-clipped state, and then when the wall comes out to push me over and remove the water, I would actually clip through the block here and land in the water tube below here. This was of course an issue, and only a workaround I found was actually jumping up when the entire thing here was moving, but that's not really a solution to this thing. But a soil sand block is not a full block, which you can see here when I'm walking on it, I'm actually falling down a short part. And that means that when this final block swapping action happens, I'm not in a clipped state, and then I'm just pushed onto this full block on the side there. So that's basically how this thing here works and why I wasn't able to completely hide it away, as I originally intended. Anyway, with that said, let's now show you how to build this elevator there. Okay, let's start with building one module. For that, we start by placing down those three blocks as you can see here. This marker block starts the corner where the elevator will be later on in. And then we have, as part of the visible floor, those two upside down stairs. Following that, let's start with a block swapper. For that, we start with sticky pistons looking at the magma block with a one wide gap in between. Then, behind this one here, by the way, the buttons will be later on the right side, so we're starting on the left side of this corner here. We need a block diagonally there with a torch on top. Then we need blocks all the way diagonally in the lower layer. Next, place down 3 redstone dust on those blocks, a repeater on 3 ticks in there, then a raised block here, another raised block there and here, and then 2 lowered blocks in there. Some redstone dust here and a repeater on 1 tick there. Torch on the side of this block, block on top and torch in there. Now the magma block should be retracted and we can replace it with our soul sand block. Following that, grab some more sticky pistons, place a 2x3 on this side, then another 3 on this side here. Grab another observer, place it right in this corner there, next to the center sticky piston there. Then place a column of 3 dispensers right diagonally to the sticky pistons there. Following that, grab some stairs, place them next to the dispensers here. Then we need another row of 3 stairs here. Now this should flatten out, since all of those stairs should be now in this corner configuration here. Make sure you have this flat wall or this will not work properly. Then on this side we need the same. Again, we should have now a completely flat wall. Following that, let's go behind the entire thing. And let's start down here with a block on top of the repeater there. We need a repeater on 4 ticks in this direction, running into a full block with a torch on the side of it, then block on top, redstone dust on top, block next to that, then a stone button or a lever or something similar on top of there, then raised block, lower block here, another repeater on 4 ticks there, then 3 blocks with redstone dust in this direction. Then we go down one layer, up a layer, place 2 repeaters on 4 ticks each, a torch right there, block on top, redstone dust on top, block to this side, torch on top, then a sticky piston in this direction with a block on top, then stairs here and there, then blocks in the corners and on this side there. Following that, let's go down here. First the sticky piston on top of the repeater there, observer in this direction. Then we need an upside down snap right here, repeater on 3 ticks in this direction, running into a full block with a torch on the side of it right there. Then block on top of this repeater, redstone wire there, torch in there. Then we need a block diagonally to the observer there, some redstone dust on top. Then another repeater on 3 ticks here, running again into a full block, another torch to the side of that one, and a full block on top of this one. Then let's actually remove this torch for a moment. And now let's place in a water bucket in each dispenser. Then let's replace the torch here. And now those stairs here should be waterlocked. Following that, let's place a block up here with some redstone wire there. Then we need a block on this side, redstone wire on top, and a torch inside of it right here. And now this whole thing here should be dry again. Next, let's go back to this corner right here. First, place the torch on this side, then remove it here. Now let's place 2 blocks up there, followed by an upside down snap here, and a block on top of this redstone wire here, then compare it in this direction, redstone wire there, a normal piston in this direction, then a torch right there. Then on top of this block, we need two blocks right in there. And again, an upside down step here, and a raised block in this corner. The comparator and the redstone dust right there. Then a sticky piston this time. Torch right here. Then a block in between the entire thing. Following that, we need two hoppers facing each other in here. Then let's go and place some items in here. For now, let's make that 16. This is essentially the timing between changing of the floor. So as long as this one here is activated, it will actually keep the entire thing activated. And then once the time has run out, it will reset the entire thing. And how many items you actually need will be figured out later on, but a quarter stack should be enough for now. Then, following that, let's actually place a block next to the redstone wire here, torch on the side of it. Then we need two blocks going up here with some redstone dust running into a full block, and then a torch on top of this, and this is essentially our connection to the module above. Then let's go down here, and actually let's place three blocks here, then grab two buttons and place them in those places here. Then while we're actually down here, place another block up there, and a last button in here. Then next, let's go down here. First, place a sticky piston below this block with an observer in this direction, and diagonally to that we need a block in there. Then below that we need a block with one height gap where we place our redstone dust, and that's the connection to the module below this one here. Next, place two redstone dust up there, then a block right in here, and on top of the dispenser there. Now we need our repeaters, so place one repeater there. And then, looking at the repeater observer right here. After that, let's go to the back here again. First, we need a sticky piston next to this block of the redstone wire. Place a redstone block below it, then another sticky piston with a one wide gap next to this. Following that, place an observer looking at the sticky piston up there. Run this into a repeater on two ticks, which again runs into a full block, then full block down here with some redstone dust on top. Following that, we need a observer right here with a node block on top, and below it. Then let's go and place another few blocks going up here, then place some redstone dust on top, and then a full block right here, cutting off this wire. And on top of the full block, we need an observer facing downwards, which is essentially the point where this line from the next higher module would lead into. Now we're getting close to finishing the entire thing. First, let's actually go behind the entire thing, and then, as you can see here, those stairs are open towards the back. Now we need blocks blocking that off. So when we now waterlock those blocks, we don't flood actually our redstone circuitry at the back there. Then we can also waterlock in those blocks at the top there. Then before we waterlock at the bottom here, first let's place blocks in those corners here. Then we need another couple blocks below here. And on this side we actually need a stairs right side up below this one here, since this way we can actually reach this button here when we are stuck in there, and then can just float up. So this is why we need a stairs right there. And don't forget to now place the blocks of the water tube itself. Then you can, as I already mentioned, waterlock those blocks at the floor here. Don't waterlock this one here, otherwise you would remove the button here involuntarily. And then of course you will have to waterlock the entire water chute right here. And the same is true for the top part here, so let's continue on with this water tube here towards the top and also waterlock this. And that's pretty much how you build one module. The next step, if you haven't already done this, is to consider how you want to have the entire thing look from the user interface here. In this case, I went with smooth quartz here. So I replaced all the stairs and such things with smooth stair where it's visible. I didn't use normal quartz blocks since this had too much of a bathroom feeling to me, especially with the somewhat visible water here due to those glitches at the back there. But anyway, once you've come to this point, it's time to copy this pattern for all floors except for the very topmost one, which is essentially just a sticky piston with a power line to it, as you can see right here. So this topmost layer essentially just has half a block swapper and the button towards the bottom module with the power line belonging to it, which, by the way, we still need to correct a bit, but more about this later on. Now let's talk about the modifications to the lowest module. Since there is no module below this one here, of course we can remove the water tube downwards. We also don't need the water locked blocks down there. And we can also remove this block with the button here and the block diagonally to it with the redstone wire on top. And at the back here we don't need the second button. And we also don't need the steel piston and the observer right here. And with that we are almost finished. Now the last part is actually interconnecting the various modules. For that we simply need to fill in two power lines or control lines. The first goes from the higher module towards the lower module, and then the second goes in the opposite direction. For the line downwards, we essentially need to send a single pulse, which can be done in the fastest way through this Fi-Fi structure here, which is two blocks, and in between we have a node block with an observer looking at it, and on top some redstone dust. If this doesn't fit completely in between here, you might need to use some kind of variation of this to fill in the gaps, but that's the general idea behind this, so let's quickly do this. So let's start at the bottom here. It's important that the last point here we have a full block with the observer on top. Then let's simply connect upwards until we reach the very top. And it should end up looking similar to this right here. So in this case, as you can see, it ended up with the node block diagonally to the observer right there, which is pretty much the optimal configuration. And with that done, let's give it a little test run. All you have to do is press the button and then see this lower module here reacting, which you can see right there. If you have the minimum distance between floors, which is 10, then all you have to do is just place a node block on top of the observer right there, and then it's also connected properly. With that done, it's time to go to the power line at the corner in here. And here we basically just build a torch tower going up all the way until we reach this point up here. But for now, let's quickly place in the last torches. And here the goal is essentially to power this block here from below with a torch. And this torch must be turned off when this here is in the normal state. So in this case, as you can see, we need essentially the same state as this torch. So the simplest solution is just put some redstone dust on top of here and then put the torch right there. In case of the minimum distance, this of course gets reduced to simply placing some redstone dust right there instead of the torch and then placing the torch right there. And that's the interconnection done. Of course, this is simplest done when the entire thing here has a multitude of two, so an even number of blocks between floors. If there is an odd number, this becomes a bit more tricky to figure out, but it's not that difficult anyway. So next up, and really the last part, is actually figuring out the timing. So as you might have noticed, at the back here we have a hopper clock, and this determines how long, when I press a button, this state here is on. So this clock here determines when I'm going up from this one here or when I'm going down from this one here, the time that stays connected. And usually it's going downwards, which takes the longest time. So the simplest solution is to gradually reduce the number of items in here, then hop in, go up, go down again, and if you still have to wait when you reached down here, then you can remove an item again. And this you do a few times until you have figured this out, which I will show you after the little cut. And I'm back again. After some trial and error, I figured out a rule of thumb you can use to roughly estimate how many items you need. So basically all you have to do is take the distance between floors, divide that by 5, and add 3. So for 10 block distance between floors, you need 5 following this rule, which is also correct. Interesting enough, in those small distances, it's actually the going upwards, which is a bit slower than the downwards due to some delays, it seems. But beyond 14 blocks or so, the relation flips over and the going upwards is faster than going downwards. Anyway, for a 30 block distance, following this rule, it's 9 blocks. And that's actually the quickest way you can use this. So let's show this first with the short one. So going downwards here. As you can see, you might need to wait a short moment, but going upwards is pretty much instantaneous, as you can see there. Here going upwards actually lets you wait at the top a bit, and you might consider actually jumping out of it, because if you are bobbing up and down and landing in the wrong time, you might actually clip through this block here and then fall down and might need to use the emergency exit. Anyway, let's go downwards, and as you can see, this now is perfectly timed essentially. You might clip your head a bit. If you have a problem with that, you can add another item here and then just wait for a few ticks down on the manga block at the bottom. And that was basically how you can build this hidden corner up and down water elevator. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!